Hi, this is Josh from Unito. Today I'm going to show you how to set up a two-way integration between Wrike and Outlook Calendar entirely from within the Wrike interface using our embedded integration. So to do this, first I'll demonstrate what this integration looks like when it's completed. So I'll set up a test event here in Wrike. I'll set a date and you'll watch it appear in my Outlook Calendar in real time. And after that, I'll show you how to build an integration like this entirely on your own. So I've just created the task here in Wrike, and there it is in Outlook. Event test 123. This event is synced with this Wrike task. And that is this task right here. And there's a link in each one that will take me to the other. And in order to build an integration that can do this, all you have to do is click on your profile, go to Apps and Integrations, and hit Project Syncs or Wrike Sync, and it will take you to this interface here, and click Create a Flow. I've already done this, so I'll walk you through the steps of my completed flow so that you can do the same on your side. So first, you'll want to connect your tools. In this case, you can select Wrike and Microsoft Outlook in whichever order you choose, as well as the accounts for each. The first time you connect your tools, you'll just need to complete a short authorization process that will allow Unito to access your tasks in that specific project or folder, as well as your calendar events in that specific calendar in order to sync them. Next up, you can choose a flow direction. So flow direction determines how new tasks or events will be created in the other tool. So in this case, I've chosen a one-way flow from Wrike into Outlook that will turn new tasks into calendar events. I could have done the opposite and choose a one-way flow from Outlook into Wrike that would have turned calendar events into tasks, or a two-way flow here would allow you to do both. For now, let's stick with a one-way flow for simplicity, and I'll show you my rules. Rules are where you can set the conditions. So if this, then that. In this case, any tasks in that specific project will appear in my Outlook calendar as an event. You can add additional conditions based on who you've assigned to the task, the color of your calendar event, anything you choose. If you'd like to filter out certain tasks from appearing in your calendar or certain events from becoming tasks, depending on which flow direction you've chosen. There's a lot of versatility in this tool, but it's very easy to use. Finally, you've got field mappings. This is where we can see the details of our tasks and calendar events. So I've got due date, end date, start date to start date, and I've set my attendees from Outlook to appear in the description footer of my Wrike task so I can keep a running list of who will be attending, as well as the description, the title, and you'll notice these directional arrows here. Just like flow direction, this is where we can determine where the changes take place and how each tool interacts with the other. So with a two-way sync here, the fields can be edited in either tool and the changes will appear in the other. Obviously, with a one-way sync here, only changes in the source tool can affect the other. So in this case, as I add or remove attendees, they'll appear in the description footer. But if I edit the description footer, nothing will happen to my attendees in Outlook. And if you choose the auto mapping function, you'll get a setup that's very similar to this. The only change that I've made is telling Unito that assignees should actually just appear in my description footer, or rather attendees, since I don't want to assign tasks to everybody who will be attending my events. And then you can hit the launch flow button. And then you can save your flow just like this, and you're good to go. And that's it. If you have any questions, don't hesitate to reach out and let us know. Thanks for watching.